Big wheels rolling, big wheels rolling, moving on. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on. Okay, welcome back to another episode of Carl's Scale Model Showcase. And before I get into today's feature, I just want to say that I sincerely appreciate all the compliments. I'm very humbled by it, and I'm very grateful for all the viewers and the new subscribers. I can't tell you enough how much I enjoy that, and having more people see my work. So just a shout out to everybody. Thank you very much, and thank you for being patient with me as I try and get a little bit better with the filming and try and get as many models to the display table as possible. On another note, I just want to reiterate the fact that I do build full-size muscle cars, real muscle cars. I have a 70 Pontiac Firebird, which I'm turning into a Trans Am, and it's coming along nicely. I've owned the car for 8 years, and I've also put up a video of my 65 Chevrolet Biscayne two-door post, which was a big block stick shift car. Now I wanted to separate the real stuff from the models, and both to me are just awesome, but I have another channel, and I'm gonna put a little card in here. It's called Cat Performance Group. That's Cat with a K, and here's the card. All right, so if you're interested in checking out those cars, my cars, take a look-see, and we'll keep this channel here strictly for the model building. So today's feature, a project I've been working on for the better part of 5 years, on and off. It keeps going to the back to its little hiding spot as I completed stuff like the Elkins wrecker and my latest truck, which was the Kenworth K100 flat top. This particular kit, this is a Revell Monogram offering of the 1/16 scale Kenworth W900 or 900L. It's basically the same kit as the 1/25th, pardon me, version. I built a black one that's on my channel, the Heavy Lift Crane Services day cab, kind of haul truck with the headache rack and the 53-foot Tritum high boy. This kit here, because it's a little bit bigger scale, not that I don't mind detailing up the 1/25th scale stuff. I have done some trucks in the past. Unfortunately, I don't have them anymore, but I've done some in the past where I've done a bunch of really extreme details to them, and you can see there's some wires kind of sticking out there. I'm gonna pull the nothing's glued together on this yet. I mean, some of it is, but I can take the cab and the hood off, and the scratch built headache rack with the fenders and everything like that. So I'm just gonna get the directions for this, and as I was saying, this is the This is it here, Monogram, the historic series. Now, pardon me, this truck, you'll see, again, it's a flat top. It had the really big bunk on it. I sold the bunk on eBay because I had plans for this truck when I first started getting into it. And so here's this is really good actually with the picture as it is right now. I'll kind of move it over now. You can kind of see there's something different with my wheels, is that I've converted these into an actual wider series wheel, a float wheel, if you will, and a float tire. I've taken two tires and I've actually converted that into a big float tire, which would be around like a 385 or something similar to what we run up here in Canada. And I've also, if you noticed, I have made the axle steerable. So that wasn't too hard to do with some pins. And being a little bit bigger scale, it just made life easy. But this kit comes with a straight axle or non-posable steering axle, and this one actually functions as it should. The steering box is going to be all tied together with the linkage, and I've got all that pinned up as well. It may look like the hood isn't quite right, but as I said, nothing's glued, nothing's completely perfectly lined up yet. So most of the frame is complete. We'll get to that here in a minute. Pardon me. And I do apologize for the lighting. I'm just going to say it straight out. My house sucks for lighting. We're hoping to change that here soon. But anyways, we're doing the best we can. So yeah, this color scheme, maybe not everybody's a fan of yellow. But we've got good things to come with this one. This is a replica of the actual truck I used to drive in the oil fields for a company called Frackmaster. Now, some people might hear the word frack and just think, oh my God, the guy's a maniac. You know, actually, I didn't work on the fracking side, although the company, that was their bread and butter, is what I did was horizontal underbalance drilling. And for those of you in a non, I guess, oil resource rich part of the world, you know, up here in Alberta, this is how we, you know, this is how we get by. This is how we make money. And I don't do that anymore. Like I said, I'm a crane operator. The only reason I really went to work for Frackmaster was because I was a truck driver and they needed somebody that could actually drive in the bush and drive in all weather conditions and put the jewelry on and stuff, which to those who don't know, that means putting your tire chains on. But, you know, I've rock and rolled it pretty good for the last 30 years. And that's why I'm such a big fan of these truck models, because, you know, I love, you know, semis and trucking. It's a love of my life. And all I can say to that is it's kind of broken the heart of my childhood dreams as to what's happened to our industry. And that's not a dig on anybody other than the powers that be who have really kind of messed it up. Anyway, I won't get into that. let's think happy here. And I mean, this is pretty cool. If you can see what's going on here, let's see here. Now, I am using a tripod again. It wiggles a bit when I adjust it. I'm just trying to get a better picture here. All right, so let's take a look at this here. So what's happened here is all this is all scratch built. None of it's stock. The fifth wheel and the plate, that's it. You know, the live roll at the back, everything like that. It's all scratch built by me. Now, what this is going to represent is inside here, I'm going to put a winch. This is going to be like a chain hanger rack. We've got some, you know, there's a light bar up here. There's going to be some lights. I'm going to bring some mud flaps off the fenders here. Again, I redid all the hubs on the wheels, and I painted the wheels because I lost the chrome part of it. What I like to do is I like to satin finish the chrome, and it comes out nice, like a true aluminum, which is what the battery box, I'll just show you the contrast here. So there's what the battery box looks like, chrome plated with the satin finish. Here's what the wheels look like, and they are just painted with the shiniest kind of silver I could find. So I know there's metallizer tricks and stuff like that. I don't currently have an airbrush right now, but thinking about getting one, and you know, we can get into some of that other stuff down the road maybe. So anyways, once again, I apologize. Spring allergies are really, really kicking my ass here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lift this off, and I made it all nicely in one piece. See that? That works out quite well, right? And see, we've got the, you know, we've got the, I'm trying to keep it, watch the camera and see what I'm doing here. So the chicken wire, you know, the check plate, I got the actual 1/16 scale check plate, some chicken wire at the back, all the square tubing in that joints have been done up real nicely and stuff like that. So basically, as it sits, the bed, it's it's pretty awesome. It's gonna look like a Canadian winch tractor. So let's put it that way. Anyways, so here we go. Now, like I said, and on this wheel, some of these wheels are real pain, but once you get them squared up, anyways, we can kind of see in here, see all that green wiring and stuff like that? It's actually supposed to depict airlines, and I've actually got them cinched up. I don't know if you can see here. Hang, bear with me, let me kind of try and zoom in. See, there's like little little copper, I use copper wire right out of a insulated wire to try and make like a, there's another one right here by this fender hole, you know, just to make it look like they're cinched up. I've got a touch up on that diff there where the U-joint goes. You know, I didn't really detail the shocks or anything like this. I mean, this is taking a lot of time. I've got some smaller wire in there for the electrical lines, for the taillights and whatnot. They run back to the taillights. The live roll isn't 100% accurate, and it's non-functional, but it's just, it is what it is, because I was trying to get that done. And anyways, you can just kind of see here. Yeah, the taillights aren't quite in yet, but they're definitely coming. So yeah, like I said, there's, you know, everything's going to the relay valves there, the check valves, all the walk and beam suspension, you know. And again, like I said, I did do some research. I am a truck driver. I don't know how many times I've said it, but you know, the airlines for the most part are correct. You know, could we have done a bit more detail on the U-joints and maybe some of the walk and beam stuff and that? Sure. But you know, like I said, a lot of it takes time. I've been messing with this for long enough too. I've even got the rail extensions on there, you know, so if a guy was sucking on a trailer or whatever, then you know, everything would roll up like it's supposed to, or slide up until it got onto the fifth wheel plate. I got some lines going into the tanks and whatnot. And I said, it, you know, it's mostly accurate. For the most part, it's accurate. But anyways, just looks kind of cool. The hood and the cab, there's going to be a red pinstripe down between the white and the yellow. And there's Frackmaster decals. Thanks again for Christy over at Graphics on Demand. She made up the Frackmaster decals for me, and the city where the truck came from or was based out of, which was Red Deer, Alberta. So that's gonna look super cool. I'm just gonna reach in here and pull the cab and the hood off. And again, Let me just get this here. So basically, we got the steering axle all together. You know, everything rolls on this one, which is pretty cool. The engine and whatnot is still not built yet. The drivetrain, the tanks need to be finished off with the filler caps and whatnot. And the there's still quite a bit of work to do on it, but for the most part, the bulk of it is done. We're not gonna, like, you know, drill out the engine for injector lines or anything like that. We're just gonna go with, you know, the basic 3408 cat, put a few details into there, tie in the airlines to the compressor, of course. And then, like I said, this steering linkage here, that's gonna actually run into the steering box. That's all gonna work as it should. And you know, I did a stainless steel finish on the tanks. I just kind of like that color, the way that silver came out. And yeah, bare metal foil the straps. I'm always a big fan of that kind of combination there, whatever. So anyways, I'm just gonna go like this. Yeah, that'll work. Let's see here. There, so that's kind of, we lost a wheel. Hey, nothing's really put together, but so we got, you know, those wheels came out kind of like that. Like I said, if you can see the yellow in the hub there, that's what we did there. And if, you know, I just go ahead and take all these wheels off. You know, I like to run that orange brake drum. There's a bit more better picture of kind of all the detail that's coming up there. Same in the front. I got the orange brake drums and stuff. See, I got all the lines tied together into the frame and stuff. So, you know, we're getting there. Do we got fittings and everything on everything? No, we don't. But, you know, and I had to notch the frame to get the rack to fit and everything like that. But, you know, it just makes it so much easier because it, you know, I got those marks in there like that, and you sit her down and away she goes, right? So it's going to be a pretty cool project when it's done, and I hope to have it completed before the end of 2021. Just a reminder out there, I am working on the Tritium Axle Wilson Cataliner, or livestock hauler, for livestock van, technically, for the K100 flat top. And that's going to be a 53 foot Tritium. So I'm going to film a video of the progress on that coming up. And once again, I sincerely appreciate all the subscribers, all the people who take time to view my work, and I'm very humbled by all the likes and the compliments. So thank you very much, and keep building those models.